In this video, I'll show you how to size a restaurant bar for occupancy. And later, I'll show you how to apply this information to nearly any restaurant bar. Coming up.
Bar Designers, International Bar Design.
Hey, Rick Usbell again from Bar Designers, where I share my ideas and tips on bar design, draft beer system design, and product reviews. Later in this video, I'll give you today's takeaway. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and check out the show notes and links in the YouTube description below. Now let's jump into the show. When you look at prospective commercial buildings, do they appear abstract? If you're in the market for a restaurant bar and don't know how to select a prospective building to match a given occupancy, you've come to the right place. From a previous video, let's again use this 4,700 square foot restaurant sports bar, which we determined to have an occupancy load of 157, as calculated by the guidelines stipulated in the International Building Code, known as IBC. Although IBC introduced revisions in 2018 for fire areas in excess of 1,500 square feet for A2 businesses serving alcohol, the method of computing occupant loads stated herein is still current. When planning buildings for prospective restaurant bars, the fact most hospitality experts agree on is that the back of the house generally accounts for 30 to 40% of the total building area. This means that 60 to 70% of the area is dedicated to front of the house, which is the area intended for customers. The 10% variance is normally the result of the complexity of the menu. Sports bars tend to require less kitchen space, whereas fine dining requires more. Now let's analyze our information. You'll note in this example that the bar and bar dining areas account for nearly 43% of the front of the house area, as well as 60% of the total occupant load. Conversely, the non-bar dining accounts for 27% of the front of the house area and 40% of the occupant load. The remaining front of the house space of 30% is dedicated to common areas. What if you're planning a new restaurant bar with an occupancy load of 100? How large would the building need to be? The above information will serve as a good template for establishing an approximate building size. But given the variation of kitchen sizes, let's focus on how the front of the house space can be predicted. If the above 3,236 square foot front of the house space yields an occupancy of 157, we could predict that an occupancy of 100 can be calculated as follows. 3,236 square feet for 157 occupants yields 20.6 square feet per occupant. So for 100 occupants at 20.6 square feet per occupant, we have a total front of the house space of 2,060 square feet. Then the size of the overall facility can be calculated as follows. 2,060 square feet divided by 0.7 equals 2,944 square feet overall. That's the total facility needed. And that yields a back of the house space of the difference between the total and the front of the house, which is 884 square feet. In round numbers, in other words, the building would need to be approximately 3,000 square feet. The next decision will be the breakdown of the dining seating. In our example, about one-third of the overall capacity is dedicated to dining seating and two-thirds to the bar area. This model is built on the success of the bar, and that makes a lot of sense because the activity of dining patrons tends to taper off several hours before closing. Secondly, the dining room is more family-friendly, and therefore we want to earmark enough capacity. A restaurant bar with an occupancy of 100 should probably have 40% of its capacity dedicated to dining tables. 10 booths would be a fine, solid approach. The remaining 60 patrons could be split between the island bar and adjacent four top tables and or booths. The building code is constantly evolving. According to my good friend, architect Tom Kuhn of CSK Architects, as of 2018, IBC now requires businesses and occupancy A2 that serve alcohol, any new or existing modified fire area over 1,500 square feet would be required to have sprinklers if you want to meet the current code without implementing workaround design parameters in Chapter 34. Always consult your local architect. I want to thank our good friends at Bullpen Luxury Sports Bar and Joe Sosimo's Pizza for their courtesy. A great place to hang out, have pizza, and watch the game. Restaurants with bars don't require large waiting areas, as many patrons enjoy waiting at the bar. See you next time.
Bar Designers, International Bar Design.